Welcome to Cadus Learning. In this session, we will learn about customizing the timeline view in Microsoft Project 2013. For this purpose, we are going to open a file from Practice Files folder. For chapter number 7, there is a practice file, simple formatting underscore start. We were working on the same file in our previous lesson as well. So if you want to keep the file open from the previous lesson, that's fine. Or alternatively, you can open this file from lesson number 7 in practice files. The default view when Microsoft Project opens this file is the Gantt chart view. And to confirm this, you can click on this little arrow beside Gantt chart. When the task tab is selected, you can see that there is a check placed beside Gantt chart. So when the Gantt chart view is open, there are two views basically. One is on the top, that's a timeline view, and one at the bottom is the Gantt chart view, as the name on the left side is telling us. And if you take a look on the ribbons, there is a format tab that is active at this time by clicking on it. And on the top of that tab, what is showing is Gantt chart tools. Now, this will change as we click in the timeline view portion. If we click in the timeline portion, the text on the format tab is going to change and it will display timeline tools. That's why the format tab is called contextual tab, because it changes the tools available depending upon where the focus is in the view. If the focus is in timeline, we have timeline tools available. If focus is in the Gantt chart view, then there are tools available are for the Gantt chart. Because we want to customize the timeline view, so let's keep the focus in there. And currently you can see that there is no task added to the timeline view at all. But because the timeline view is a more compact view and it provides a high-level view of all the summary tasks in the project, therefore, at times, this view performs better than the Gantt chart. So let us click on the existing task in the insert group when the format contextual tab is selected. And on existing tasks, let us add few tasks to the timeline view. So we have selected planning phase, and planning phase complete is a milestone. Let's add that as well. Let's add the summary task internal launch phase and public launch phase as well as author travel and appearance. Press OK. And alternatively, you can accomplish the same thing, but that we will show in a bit. Anyway, once you have added all these milestones and summary tasks to the timeline view, you can see that the view has changed. And now it is showing the tasks which are added to this timeline view. This divider line at the bottom of this view can be pulled down in order to make more room available for this view. And all the elements in this view are also customizable. For example, if you take a look on this one, on this first portion or first element of the timeline view, this is fully customizable because we can change the font size here. We can change the font style if we want to. And also, we can change the font color, the background color. Let's take a look on how the background color can be changed. If we were to apply this background color, we obviously can apply the background color as well. And if you are not satisfied with this freedom of customization, you can still click on the font dialog box launcher and it will open up all the options which are available for customization of this timeline view. So for now, let's apply this background here and apply the same background color to all the elements. We could have changed all the other font sizes as well. Let's change the font sizes to 14 for all the elements that are available over there. But this author travels, the task that we have added, author travel and appearance, that you can see that it is appearing below another task because it is starting at the same time as the other task is starting. And there is less room for it because it completes in one specific window of time, which is very small. And that's why the full text of the task is not appearing in here. So what do we do about it? Because if we just print it or view it just the way it is not going to show us the lot of information that we need to show on the timeline view. Therefore, for customization of this, let us keep this task selected. And while the format tab is active, let us go to the current selection group. On the current selection group, let us click on display as call out. And now you can see that task which was smaller in size and we were not able to get the full view of that task, we have applied the display as call out command to make it appear above the bar, and we can also change its font size as well as if we want to change the font, the background as well, we can change the background. But no, this didn't apply to the callout. Callout has its own formatting styles. Anyway, now we are going to add another task to the timeline view. And for this, we are going to scroll all the way down and check the task name, launch complete with ID number 24. If we want to add this task to the timeline view, either we can right click on the task name and then add to timeline, or what can we do is we can simply keep this task selected, and on the task tab we can go all the way to the right in properties group and click on add to timeline command. Once you click on this add to timeline command, you can see that this task is added at the end. So let us change the font size for this as well. Let's change the font size to same 14. And now we have a lot better look and feel of the timeline view. And we can further customize it to our liking, whatever we want. So this is it. But before we end this, I want you to take notice of these green lines which are appearing in the form of rectangle. And if you drag this upper or bottom line, we can see that it in fact causes the scroll in the Gantt chart view as well. So this way, if our views in the Gantt chart, if these tasks are not viewable in the Gantt chart view, we can, using this, we can certainly navigate it back and forth on the time. But if we use this vertical line divider, this is going to zoom. So you can see that this is zooming in on the time scale. So we can use these sliders, and this, by the way, is called the pan and zoom feature, which is available under the format tab. We can use this slider, the left or right, in order to zoom, and the top or bottom we can use to move on the time scale on the left or right. And if we want to turn this feature off, obviously if we just click pan and zoom off, that zoom and off feature as a pan and zoom feature is going to be turned off. So it gives us a fully customizable view of the timeline, which at times could be the best view for the stakeholders, because every view does have its own use. In our next lesson, we will see how we can customize reports.